with the double Logie winner, who has played a cop, a crook, a cricketer, and this weekend we will see him in a whole new light. Please welcome Gary Sweet, Studio 10. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Funnily enough, we actually have a beautiful studio cameraman here who played Dexter in A Perfect Match.
Is that right?
Yeah. Say g'day, Hermie.
Hello.
Thanks, Sarah. Hermie's a lot taller, than I expected.
It's very hard to get
it's,
into.
It's a running joke that we have. Hey, Wake and Fright. This is, you know, an iconic TV, or iconic movie that's been transformed for television. Tell us about it.
Yeah, it's a, well, the original, I think, was made in 1971. Mm. I mean, it's so old that Jack Thompson had a non-speaking part in it.
Wow.
Yeah. But, and I think Chips Rafferty was the lead in those. And it was made by an American. It had Donald Pleasance, had a lot of British actors in it. But this is a four-hour miniseries, and it's a bit more faithful to the book than the movie. So, yeah, I think you get a better feel of the whole...
It's really extraordinary on a number of levels. I know all about Wake and Fright, and I'm fascinated by it, but I actually never saw the movie. So I watched the first part of the miniseries cold, not having seen the movie. And it is, I mean, it's amazing the sort of things it delves into. It's very deep in a lot of ways. And you, who's Australia's hero, play this kind of sinister... Guy, tell us a bit about your character.
It's a while ago, Joe. I can't quite remember what we were doing that. No, no. No, I play, well, I don't know. I play a real estate agent. So,
evil, pure evil.
No, it's not evil. It's just a little bit creepy. I think, you know, just...
I mean, that's the whole thing about this thing, isn't it? It's what lies beneath. On the surface, everything seems just fine. But there's this really sinister undertone, isn't it?
Yeah, there is. And I guess that's the thing about it. You know, it's implicit too. There's not any graphic violence in it, particularly, but there's all this stuff happening. Nice goatee, you.
but as you say, though, it is. There's this almost sinister undertone. This sort of sense of growing. Oh, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? And often I think with the Australian bush and the outback, there is that sense, like the landscape lends itself to that very much.
It's funny because there's quite a feeling of claustrophobia about it. Mm. You know, there's this kind of pressure, this kind of impending pressure. But then when you find yourself within the landscape, there's nowhere to go. It's like, oh, it's so vast, there's nowhere safe, there's nowhere
comfortable. It almost becomes a character as well.
It's almost a bit like Australia's Heart of Darkness, isn't it? It's the thing about the civilised man from... the big city, in this case Sydney, you know, going out to the great unknown, and almost the locals in the outback are almost kind of like this sort of strange, they're almost like a foreign species to him.
It's like weirdo city, you know, like everybody's really strange, or everybody's harbouring a big secret.
Yeah.
Which we all kind of are in a way.
Really?
What's your secret?
But appearances always.
But I mean, everyone has a story. I suppose that's what I mean.
Well, yeah.
But you filmed in Broken Hill.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Broken Hill.
Yes. What was that like?
Well, Broken Hill, I've got a good story about Broken Hill. I first went there when I was 13, I think. Mm-hmm. I grew up in Adelaide, and a friend of mine came from Broken Hill. So I went to Broken Hill with him in 1970, I think. And we stayed with his grandparents. And when I went back there this year, his grandpa was still there. He was 104.
Oh, wow.
It was amazing. It was great to see him. Unfortunately, I'm glad I went to see him because he passed away sometime afterwards. Mm. But it was wonderful to see him. And I've never seen anybody that's 104.
I was going to say, 104 is a pretty good innings.
Wow.
Did he have wisdom to impart?
Yeah, he said, a lot of things I can't repeat.
I mean, 104 years old and still in Broken Hill, that is actually Wake and Fright.
And I remember going down the zinc mines and all that sort of stuff in those days, you know. But, of course, the mines are... a lot of the mines are shut now.
Yeah.
And that's part of the story of...
That's right, it's a new one. I like that it's got that you know, the mines moved on, everything shut down, it's just those people left behind.
Yeah.
Gary, I'm really excited about this one.
Are you?
I made my twins watch it the other day. Muriel's Wedding.
Oh, yes.
It's coming to the stage. I can't think of a more perfect musical.
Well, yeah, it's pretty good. It's a lot of hard work at the moment. Because
we're you're in rehearsals.
Well, how dare you? If I was easily offended... I mean, it's a big musical.
They have cast me.
That's right.
You're playing.
Do you sing in the white police rescue overalls? That's what Jess wants to know.
No, but I have. Ooh. I have before. Yeah, we used to have a band called Cop This.
Really? So you can then sing and dance.
Well, let's just say I can get by.
Fun. That must be great fun.
It's a lot of fun for me. I don't know if it's a lot of fun for everybody else, but yeah. No, I'm an excellent shower singer, and I'm trying to, you know, move into musical theatre. No, it's a lot of fun.
You're actually taking on Bill Hunter's role.
Correct.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah, right. Is that a bit daunting stepping into his big?
It is, because he was such a legend, Bill Hunter, and a great mate of mine. You know, he'd either. When I used to run into him, he'd either kiss me or headbutt me, depending on how many beers he'd have at the time. But, yeah, I loved Hunter. We worked together many, many times over the years, and in some ways I'm hoping for a sign, you know. He'll give me a sign at some stage.
I was going to say, I'm pretty sure it was enshrined in Australian law that Bill Hunter has to be in every single Australian movie ever made.
Oh, well, yeah, I mean, he's just so bizarre. There he is. Look at him. I've got him starting to look like him. No!
What do you look like? Who's that? Marty Sachs.
I tell you who says that the most, Marty Sachs' kids.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. So your mates, are you mates?
Yeah, 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 wow. Good friends. And Marty told me a story once that I was on TV and his kid said, Dad! He goes, he's not your dad. That's not your dad.
Do you see any resemblance, Jess, between Gary and
Marty? Oh, stop it.
Oh, what's that?
No,
this a big secret you're telling? What's going on?
Secret.
Come on.
No, it's not a big secret, but just many years ago,
yes.
When I was so much younger, Marty was so much younger, we used to date.
Yes.
Really? Really?
Yes.
That's why she's been eyeing you off.
No, not
that's
true. Right.
Jess
was a young love.
That's right.
That's why she wanted to
sit next
to you. They broke up after she kept calling him Gary. So.
Yeah, right.
No, he was a big love, and they're still great mates.
Yeah, but he's
lovely.
Just,
he's very nice.
That you guys
he's
are just
really
very
great.
Look-alike. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. And can I say, you two guys look great together.
Thank you. Yeah, very attractive couple.
This is sufficiently awkward.
I want to know more about your singing and dancing. Can you sing a bit for us before we go? Like an ABBA. Mama mia.
I would trust.
Here I go again. Mama, can I resist?
That's good. Unfortunately, there's
Mama
no duet
mia,
with that one.
Oh.
Yeah. No,
Mama.
I can't.
Dancing queen, Gary, sweet only servant.
No, I can't because my song is a big surprise.
Well, you are just a legend. Thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you very much for having me. Thank you.
He's also multi-talented. You can catch him in Muriel's Wedding, the musical, by heading to sydneytheatre.com.au. And, of course, Wake in Fright, the miniseries, begins at 8:30 Sunday night right here on the 10 and Win Network.
Very, very
great to see you, Gary.
Yeah.
Very nice to be here. Thank you. Thank you.